Hello students, welcome once again to our channel. In this video we are going to see class 12 physics electrostatics chapter 1 2-3 mark question and answer. This is the part 5 of this video series. Don't forget to subscribe and share it with your friends. Come on, let us move on to the question. Question number 19. Write a short note on superposition principle. Answer: the total force acting on a given charge is equal to the sum of forces exerted on it by all the other charges. F1 total is equal to F12 vector plus F13 vector plus F14 vector plus F1n vector. What does it mean? Let us suppose there is a charge. Around that charge there are other charges also present. So each and every charge is exerting a force on that particular charge. So the total force acting on a given charge is equal to the sum total of the charges exerted on it by other charges that are present around it. That is the meaning of this answer. So for example, a charge. Let us take that charge as charge 1. So the charge number 1 experiences a total force which is equal to the charge exerted by the charge 2 plus the charge exerted by the charge 3 plus the charge exerted by the charge 4. Like that it goes on, and finally the charge exerted by the nth charge on this charge 1. So the sum total of all the forces exerted by these charges is equal to the total force acting on a given charge. Next question, question number 20. What is meant by electric field lines? Electric field lines are a set of continuous lines which are the visual representation of the electric field in some region of space. So these electric field lines are nothing but a set of continuous lines drawn in between a positive and a negative charges. Actually, they are the visual representation or the pictorial representation of the electric field in some region of space. Next question. Write down the general definition of electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment is equal to the product of the magnitude of one of the charges and the distance between them. Now, let us take a dipole. What is meant by a dipole? Two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance is called a dipole. Now, have a closer look at this diagram. This is the structure of a dipole. Two equal charges, that they are Q and Q, but they are opposite in nature. This is minus Q and this is plus Q. They are separated by a small distance which is equal to 2A. So the distance in between this minus Q and plus Q is 2A. This setup makes a dipole. Now here we are going to define the dipole moment. For that, we need to take any of these two charges, either you take minus Q or a plus Q, and multiply it with the distance in between them, that is 2A. That is nothing but dipole moment. Now see, electric dipole moment is equal to the product of the magnitude of one of the charges. Here two charges are there. You take the magnitude of any one of these two charges and multiply it with the distance between them, that is 2A. So this small p stands for electric dipole moment, which is equal to one of the charges, that is Q, and the distance in between them is 2A. So p is equal to Q into 2A. Now unit, how do we get this unit? Coulomb meter. What is the unit of Q? That is charge coulomb. Here 2A is nothing but the distance. So the unit for distance is meter. So the unit for electric dipole moment is coulomb meter. Next question. What is an equipotential surface? An equipotential surface is a surface on which all the points are at the same electric potential. Now, take any surface with the condition. On a surface, if all the points that lie on the surface have the same electric potential, then we call that surface as an equipotential surface. Now come to the definition. An equipotential surface is a surface on which all the points are at the same electric potential. Next question. Define electric flux. The number of electric field lines crossing a given area kept normal to the electric field is called electric flux. Now have a closer look at this diagram for better understanding. Here comes a positive charge. From this positive charge, electric field lines emanate or originate. So these parallel lines represents the electric field lines that come out of this positive charge. Now place an area or a surface perpendicular to the electric field lines. Now, the number of electric field lines crossing this given area, which is placed perpendicular to the direction of the electric field, is called electric flux. Hope you would have understood clearly. Now come to the definition once again. The number of electric field lines crossing a given area kept normal, that is perpendicular to the electric field, is called electric flux. With this video has come to an end. Let us meet in the next video with another set of questions.